attention. Okay. I apologize for that. Hey, before we get started, I know there's a lot of you sitting back in the back. I have to tell you, Mrs. Weaver does a fantastic job of taking care of me. She always gets me these nice seats right up here. I've got three seats over here, and my girls and I, we can stand. We were sitting a lot today. So if any of you back there have three people and need a seat, please come up and have these. These are great seats up here. More than happy to have you guys come up there and sit. So anybody back there, come on up. Feel free to take those. I see somebody heading right now. That's perfect. And girls, they're going to sit over there for me. Okay, just wait for me right over there. We'll be ready to go. Awesome. I'm going to go ahead and turn this one on so we don't have another technical problem here. We're going to go ahead and get started. I got a lot of information here. We're going to do the disclosure first on the taking pictures and videos. You guys are more than welcome to take those. Just keep them for personal use. Don't put them on social media, that kind of stuff. Some of the music and things that they use are copyrighted, and that violates our copyright with them. So I want to thank RTC for coming out tonight. They're going to be videotaping tonight. They will have this airing on Channel 4 in a couple of days. And if you guys would like to make a purchase, and you'd like to have a copy of it, contact RTC and they'll get you squared away on that. Again, welcome to tonight's second grade spring concert. The name of this concert is Sing Me a Story About Weather. The second graders have been doing a unit on weather, and to finish it off, they're going to have a concert about it. What's unique about this concert is it's kind of hard to find songs, second grade level, that deal with weather. So what they do is a lot of the songs that you're going to hear tonight, they created themselves. Their classes made these songs. They wrote these songs, and that makes it really special, makes it extremely awesome. A lot of songs incorporate facts about the units and what they learned in the last month. I want to recognize the classes, Mrs. Scheidlers, Mrs. Banks, Mrs. Musselman, Mrs. Malco, Mrs. Gongwer, Ms. Sewell, and Ms. Ramsey will all be performing. The entire second grade will be performing tonight. I want to thank, I've got a whole laundry list of people to thank, but the second grade teachers, the IAs, our custodians, Mrs. Freeman, they've all been working really hard with the kids to get them prepared and get them ready, so I appreciate all that time. The office staff does a lot to help with coordinating transportation to the high school and getting them all set up, so I want to thank my office staff for all of their help. The Columbia family in general, yesterday when we did a rehearsal, we had tons of classes from the kindergarten and first grade and everybody else come down and participate in that. And it truly is a family event when we do these types of things. I've got to tell you, I don't know, Mrs. Weaver, are you back there? Can you come out here for just a second?
If I could find my way.
I know I'm interrupting your preparations. But ladies and gentlemen, Mrs. Weaver puts a ton of time into these concerts. And it's not for any recognition for herself. It's simply just because she cares about the kids and she cares about helping them out and giving them a great experience. I'd like for everybody to just give her a round of applause. These things are awesome. We're very blessed to have her working with our kids along with all of our other staff at our building. So thank you, Mrs. Weaver. I'm going to get you started here in just a second, I promise.
Gotcha.
Doesn't know where they're going. Okay. All right. We have, and I'm sure you guys have been hit by the flu bug and the coughs and the sniffles as my family has. So we've got a couple of kids that were had certain parts, special parts, that were unable to attend tonight due to sickness. So we're plugging in some different people into those roles. Just wanted to let you know that. Ice Cream Social will be in the cafeteria, which is right behind where you're sitting right now. And that's going to be sponsored by our PTO. I want to give a special thanks to our PTO. They're very supportive of all of the different events that we do in our school. We have a lot of volunteers, a lot of parents, and Michelle, who leads our PTO, does a fantastic job. So if you'd like to get some ice cream afterwards and support that, that would be awesome. It's a dollar, and all the proceeds go back to the school, and they do a lot for our kids. So. The last bit of information that I have for you guys is after the concert. At the end of the concert, students and Mrs. Banks, Mrs. Musselman, just those two will be in the library to pick up your kids. If you guys can just, everybody just wait until we get all the kids off the stage and give them, I'll let you know when, then we'll go out and get them. That way they can get in there and it'll be a lot easier to find and we're not having people picked up in the hallways. Students in Mrs. Ramsey and Mrs. Scheidler's class will meet in the conference room beside the library. That's room 101, and it's all the way at the end of this hall right over here. And Mrs. Gongwer and Mrs. Malko's class will meet in the choir room, which is behind the stage. And Mrs. Sewell's class wasn't listed in there, but I believe she was in the library as well. So that's where you guys will pick everybody up. And I believe that is all of my announcements. I really do appreciate you guys coming. Second grade, we're down to about eight or nine weeks left at Columbia. I just want to thank everybody in here, parents, family members, for all your support in helping the second graders get to where they're at today. They're going to be leaving awesome students and ready for their riddle challenges. So this will be the last time I'll formally be able to address you. So thank you guys, everybody in here, for all of your support for our kids and our second graders. And we'll not be happy to turn them over to riddle because we're going to miss them. But we know they're going to be ready to go. And they're going to do a fantastic job there. So without further ado, here's our second grade class, and enjoy your evening. Thank you.
We are not just here to tell you about the weather. We wrote songs so that we could sing you a story about weather.
Our first song tells us about the weather.
The water cycle is a big part of it. The water cycle is where the water takes as it goes from the land to the sky and back again.
Please listen to the song around the water cycle written by the students in Mrs. Banks' class. The team of American folklore will be coming on the mountain.
Sun is an important part of the weather.
sun not only heats up the earth, it also helps plants grow. We get solar energy from the sun.
The heat from both sun helps the water from both as part of it. Water cycle.
Our next song is about the sun. It was written by Eskimos in his class to the tune of Argentine and we'll call it Argentine.
Why did the weather ask for privacy?
It wanted to change.
What did the North Pole say to the equator?
You're a hot stuff.
Why did the whale fish the tiger or anyone else?
She thought it was a prince.
What ball never gets hurt?
I don't know what ball that never gets hurt.
Okay, I'll give you a sign and next time tells us about the seasons.
It was written by Miss Sue's class. It is sung to the tune of one of our favorite songs, Down by the Bay.
Step.
The clouds found in the middle of the atmosphere are also cumulus or alto clouds. Sometimes the low clouds get so low it touches the ground. We call that fog.
If nimbus is part of the cloud name, that means that clouds carry precipitation.
Cumulus nimbus clouds are really big clouds. They are sometimes called thunderheads.
This song called Types of Clouds was written by Mrs. Ramsey's class. We wrote it to the tune of Jingle Bells.
Thank you. Take off. of the Year featuring second grader Audrey Boone.
Best of it and have a zippy doodle day.